I think Microsoft could be wrong and missing something huge, and I also think JayzTwoCents is right. You see, last week I talked about how a ton of people were reportedly having their SSDs basically die after a recent Windows update, specifically KB5063878. And since that video, Microsoft has released a statement basically saying, well, we couldn't reproduce it, and our telemetry data doesn't suggest that there's an increase in drive failures, and also our customers aren't reporting it. So you might think, well, case closed, right? Maybe it's just a normal level of SSD failures not related to the update, but more people were talking about it, and then other people maybe were exaggerating just to slam Microsoft. However, I'm going to systematically explain, in my opinion, why I do think there could still very well be a problem, and why Microsoft telemetry may not even show it at all, and why they could be missing the bigger picture. Now, to be very, very clear, even if there is a problem, it's extremely possible that it's not even Microsoft's fault, and their update simply uncovered an issue that already existed in the SSD controllers. I just want to point that out before anyone gets out all the pitchforks. Now, first of all, the number one reason why I think this is actually a legitimate issue is after JayzTwoCents made a video where he actually showed it happening to him on his actual computer and he's able to reproduce it. I do highly recommend you watch his video after this one. I am going to base a lot of my points on the stuff he showed in this video, but I am going to add some additional insights that I don't think anyone has talked about before. Basically, in his video, he talks about and shows how when running a certain benchmark, he's able to pretty consistently cause that failure where the drive would disappear. And he didn't actually mention this in the video, but I noticed it, is that the drive failure happens during the loading phase of the benchmark. I'll come back to that point in a second though. It's also very relevant that he's working on a test bench in this case, where presumably you want to change as little stuff over time in terms of software so you can test the hardware apple to apples, which means that probably there's not a lot that has changed on that computer except for the Windows update. Unfortunately, I guess he's not able to actually fully roll back the update because I guess the update actually also installed a servicing stack because he did try to uninstall and roll back the update, but apparently it still happens. So it's possible that the problem isn't even from the security updates, but the servicing stack along with it. Not going to get into that. Anyway, interestingly, he mentions in his video how the problem that he's experiencing, obviously during a benchmark, is not the normal reported situation that would cause this issue. And he says he even tried doing the other tests like copying large files and even running Crystal Disk Mark, stuff like that, and it wouldn't cause it, but this benchmark would. So that might suggest to a lot of people, oh, well, it's not simply just from heavy reading and writing. It must be something else. However, one thing I want to point out, like I said before, is that the crash he experiences does happen during the loading phase of the benchmark. And that's important because when you're loading it or loading files into memory, not only are you actually reading from the drive, but what you might not realize is Windows has what's called a page file, where it basically moves less used parts of the memory onto the disk. So in this case, if you're loading a lot of new stuff into memory, even if it's not overflowing or pushing the boundaries, Windows might decide to move stuff out of memory onto the disk. So my point is, it still very well could be related to doing heavy writes on the disk. One way that Jay could test this directly is by disabling the page file in Windows and then rebooting and then seeing if it still happens with it disabled, because that would presumably just load it into memory but not have any writes at the same time of that. And if it doesn't ever happen again, then that would mean that the theory that all of this is related to heavy writing, at least in part, still holds. Now, to be clear, this is not to suggest in any way that the page file is causing all this, so do not go disabling that. It's just a way to test and confirm in his specific scenario that the problem is still actually related to writing to disk, just in a different way than copying files. And one more point that I think Jay could test is, I don't know if he's been monitoring the temperatures of the SSDs, but I'd be curious if the one that he was testing had a heatsink on it, and I'd be curious if it didn't, if adding one would fix it, because I assume that SSDs do have some kind of temperature throttling built in, but hey, maybe that's the problem. Something messed that up. But that's just a random thought that I had. Finally, another thing that he talks about, and I think is very relevant, and I'll come back to it, when he does a normal restart, the drive appears gone. And it's not until he does a full power cycle by actually turning off the power supply and then turning back on that the drive comes back. And I think that's relevant because there was that one set of testing that the person on Twitter did where they found that, at least in a couple cases, the drives would not come back. And people were saying, well, that means that it's killing the drives. But I wonder if these drives, even the ones that seemingly don't come back, are not actually being bricked, but they just need to be fully power cycled. So that is my first of a couple key theories and hypotheses that I have in this video. And that is that I think even when this problem does happen, it's probably not actually bricking the SSDs. Even if it doesn't come back with a restart, it might just be that you need to do a full power cycle. So before I even continue, I'm gonna address this point further. I know a lot of people are gonna ask, should I resume Windows updates if I disabled it before? Should I, you know, install this update? And in my opinion, yes, I think you actually should continue Windows updates, even though I also think this problem is real. The first reason being, it seems that even if this is a problem, it's still probably rare. And like I just talked about, I think in basically all cases, the SSD will be recoverable by just doing a full power cycle. And by that, I mean shutting down and then also turning off your power supply, then turning it back on. All right, now my second theory and hypothesis is I wonder if this problem is caused not purely just from writing large files, but also simultaneously writing and reading. Because you might remember that one Twitter user who did all the testing, NecoroCat, he did three stages of tests. One, copying a file from another drive onto the test drive. Then in the next test, he compressed all those files into an archive on the same drive. And then in the third stage, he extracted those onto the same drive. And in his results, by far, most of the problems happened in those second and third stage, not the first. A couple happened in the first, but it was mostly the second and third where it involved both writing and reading to the drive at the same time. Because in the second one, you're reading from the file and then also writing to the compressed archive you're creating. And the third stage, you're doing the opposite, reading from the archive and then writing the file. Now, yes, a couple drives did fail in the first stage. So I think at the very least, it makes it more likely to fail in the second and third, or maybe some drives are just more susceptible when both reading and writing, whereas not just for writing. And again, going back to Jay's video about having the crash during the loading phase of the benchmark, that would also be reading from the files and then also writing back to the page file. So for example, if he's running several different benchmarks, one possibility just off the top of my head is maybe if the program loads a bunch of different maps into the memory and Windows sees that it's done with one of them, it could just move it into the disk on the page file since it's not using it anymore. Now, I don't know how big the files that it's actually loading into memory are, but presumably if it's a benchmark, it's probably gonna be loading the biggest ones. And it is a very large game at like 100 gigabytes total. Obviously it's not gonna load all that at once, but it still is probably big files. Now again, obviously there has to be more to it. And also Jay mentioned in his video that he did even do some testing through like Crystal Disk Mark and other stuff copying files, and it didn't happen with him, only during the benchmark. Anyway, so my point is that if anyone's gonna plan on doing testing to try and reproduce this, you might wanna focus on a thing that would test both reading and writing simultaneously heavily. Next, another major thing I want to talk about is how Microsoft said in their memo that their telemetry that they analyzed does not suggest an increase in drive failures. But one thing I realized today when I was thinking about it is in the case of a primary system drive failure, there would be no way for Windows to even submit an error report for them to even know about it in the first place. You see, for errors and crashes, Windows has what's called Windows Error Reporting, WER, where it will create a file on the disk with what happened and sometimes even include part of the memory that was related to that application that crashed. And then later it will upload that file to Microsoft so they can get a report of different crashes and then work on them. And if Windows itself crashes, it can actually include a copy of just what Windows itself was doing. This is called a dump file, and then upload it again to Microsoft. That's usually what happens if you get a BSOD. You'll see it says 0% complete or preparing report. I forget what it says, but it does something before shutting down and it's creating that dump file and that report to later upload. But in the case where the main system drive just disappears, then there would be no disk to create that report file on, so it can't send it. And you'll actually notice in JayzTwoCents video, when he gets that BSOD, it pretty much instantly goes away. Normally that takes time, again, because it has to create the whole report, but it doesn't. It just says 0% complete and instantly goes away without progressing past that, because obviously it's unable to create the report to send. Now, I have no idea if Microsoft has other ways where they can somehow send off telemetry data purely from memory via the internet, even if the disk disappears, but it's also not inconceivable that whatever is causing this problem could also be causing that to not work. So I will point out that if you are someone who recently started experiencing more and more BSODs than usual, and you notice that the blue screen goes away pretty much instantly, that very well could actually mean that you are experiencing this problem, and it's just that your motherboard happens to reboot in a way that causes the drive to come back and is able to recover from it, or maybe the drive is just able to recover from it anyway. So that is something I would watch out for. Another thing I want to touch on is in JayzTwoCents video, he mentions and shows how it's kind of what he describes as a slow crash, where first the benchmark freezes and then it goes to the desktop and Windows kind of acts glitchy and then shows an error and then dies. And that is actually what I would expect to happen if the drive just instantly disappeared. Windows is going to keep running for a short amount of time purely from memory, because it's running from memory. It's just that it's going to kind of take a minute to realize something's very wrong and then die. It's kind of like the old cartoons where the coyote is chasing the roadrunner and he runs off a cliff, but it takes him a second to realize that there's nothing underneath him. It's kind of like Windows doing that. And the reason I think that Microsoft would not necessarily catch this in the telemetry at all is because even if this happens and Windows notices the drive is gone and crashes because of that, well, it can't write the report, like I said, and then even when Windows reboots and it sees, based on whatever flag it sets for having a successful shutdown, it's gonna see, whoa, there was not a successful shutdown. But anything that happened after the drive just disappeared is not gonna be reported on. So it's not gonna know exactly what even happened. I think it'll probably look exactly the same as if the user had just cut power to the computer. It's gonna know that there was a shutdown of some kind that was not expected, but without any kind of error report, it has no idea what happened. And the fact that Microsoft says that there's not really any telemetry about this kind of does suggest to me that the problem is at the hardware level within the SSDs, because if there was something starting to go wrong with Windows, you would think that it would probably start to write that data to the disk before it completely died. But it seems to me like maybe the drive just is instantly failing and disappearing before it even tells Windows what's going on. So my third hypothesis here is that if this problem is really happening, it's not going to show up in the telemetry at all. Microsoft might have to look at other indirect signals, and I'm sure they probably did. In their memo, they mention that the telemetry doesn't suggest an increase in failures. So it's not like they say, well, Windows didn't say it failed, so it must not have. I'm assuming they were looking at other stuff, but still, maybe not. Maybe they were literally just looking at that and haven't considered it. Now, finally, I want to address Microsoft's point in the memo where they said that they haven't received reports of customers experiencing this issue. But I think even if the problem is real, there is a pretty reasonable explanation for that. And that is that, one, it's probably still rare. And second, it's probably not permanently bricking the SSDs, so there's kind of a low incentive to even bother reporting it. So let me explain. Like I mentioned, it seems like, in my opinion, I would expect that in all cases, or at least a very, very vast majority, fully power cycling the SSD should bring back the SSD. I think the reports of where people said that it bricked it, where they tried restarting and it still didn't appear, I would expect that if they fully power cycled it, it would bring it back. And the reason we're seeing reports about certain drives permanently being bricked is because in a testing environment, what's someone going to do to see if that drive is permanently bricked? They might just restart the computer. They might not do a full power supply off cycle. And if they are doing a testing and they restart and the drive still doesn't come back, maybe even they restarted a couple times, but if they never fully power cycle off the computer, they're just going to assume it's dead and then shut down the computer all the way to simply take out that drive and move on to the next one, never actually trying it again. And like Jay touched on, a lot of people might not even be noticing that they're experiencing this drive disappearance if their motherboard automatically does a power cycle on some restart, because in that case, it would just look like a quick blue screen and they would never see the drive gone. Another important thing to consider is not everyone reads tech news all the time. Most people probably have no idea that this potential issue is even being discussed. So for most people, especially people in a business environment, even if they have this happen, they'll probably just restart the computer, or even if they get another error where they restart it and it still doesn't work, then what's the usual next step that people always say? Oh, we'll turn it off for 30 seconds, turn it back on, and then they'll see that it came back and then think, oh, that was weird, and then go back to normal life and not ever bother reporting it to Microsoft. And also, most people are not even going to know how to even access the BIOS or want to. So they're not going to see, oh, my SSD is gone. They're going to see my computer's not booting. And that will be the conclusion that they come to. I also want to point out that some people on Reddit say that they are IT managers for fleets of computers, thousands of computers. And I think in a business environment, it probably just doesn't have the workloads necessary for doing very large files that would be triggering this type of issue. Like, what are you working with Excel? You're not writing 50 gigabyte files. Now, again, some people might be experiencing that, but think about it this way. Even if there are some people in that business fleet and they're experiencing issues, first of all, they would have to experience the problem enough to notice it as a recurring problem, and then go to your IT department and report it and say, hey, my computer randomly started BSODing a lot, or my computer won't boot. And then they're gonna say, okay, have you tried turning it off, power cycling it, turn off for 30 seconds, all that sort of stuff, and it'll probably fix it. So kind of the reporting stage would stop at the company level, the IT department. And if that IT department only sees one user that it happens to, they're not going to think of it as a pattern to report to Microsoft. They're just going to think, oh, well, this person's computer glitched out, but it's fixed now. So all of that is to say that I don't think them not getting reports about it is necessarily evidence that it's not happening. And I also think in this particular problem, the telemetry would not show it either. Now, one quick thing about Microsoft saying that they couldn't reproduce this internally, that really does not surprise me. It's very clear that this is a pretty specific circumstance that would have to cause this, and it's very probable that they just didn't try it. So just because they, on their testing, I don't care how many hours of testing they did, if they weren't actually doing the thing that causes the problem, of course it's not going to show up. So I'm not convinced by that. Now, some final other thoughts. I do kind of wonder if maybe this problem was happening a little bit earlier than this exact update. Maybe it was a slightly earlier update and it's only now that people started noticing it. So that being said, I don't think you have to worry too much about file loss. I think we really would have heard more about that if that was actually fully bricking SSDs. I don't think that's the case. So I don't think you have to necessarily worry about it. But if you do start, again, experiencing quick BSODs where it's not reporting, then I would start reaching out to Microsoft and mention that. So if you're wondering what's going on with that update, that's the latest information we have and my theories about it. If you want, you can watch my previous video where I talked about it. I'll put that link right there, as well as JayzTwoCents video there and also in the description. So I recommend watching both of those probably, but you can decide which first. Anyway, as usual, thanks for watching. If you want to subscribe, I make videos about twice a week, so it should be worth it. So I'll see you in the next one.